Well, he burst into our lives as the Naked Chef more than 20 years ago.
Naked's what I call my way of cooking. What I cook in the restaurant isn't what I cook at home. Cooking's got to be a laugh.
It's got to be simple, it's got to be tasty, it's got to be fun.
I suppose you could say it's stripping down the recipe to its bare essentials.
No way, it's not meat, it's
the food.
Jamie Oliver has emerged from Britain's lockdown and is back doing what he does best, and that is bringing people together. And he says anyone can entertain, even cooking-challenged people like myself. Check out my private cooking lesson with Jamie Oliver.
Wow, food superstar Jamie Oliver, it's so good to see you and your kitchen.
It's lovely to see you and so nice to be cooking together today.
Oh, well, can I just say, just to begin with, this isn't my actual kitchen. My real kitchen looks nothing like this. I failed home economics in high school. Not very comfortable with cooking, so a private lesson with you is quite thrilling and terrifying at the same time. Where do we start?
Okay, well, look, in the new book, it's all about bringing people back together. And I know in Sydney you're locked down, but the world is beginning to open up again. And I think we all know that feeling of how important it is to be able to have legally your friends and family around your house. Throw a dinner party. So this is one of the meals. In front of you, you have got some prawns.
Yes.
You've got John Dory, which I love. And we've got some lovely scallops. Use any combination of fish or shellfish, anything sustainable, anything that's good. You can have fun with it. We're going to do a little marinade for the fish first. So I just want to pound up some ginger. Now, you've done yours already because you are utterly efficient.
I have. I don't have people for this. I've been really putting the elbow grease into this, Jamie, and I've made it a gorgeous orange paste. That then goes on top of the fish?
Yeah, well, look, this is just... a marinade can be a very, very simple thing, but ultimately it's about getting flavour on food or, you know, fish or meat. So just pound that up. I'm going to use a really fantastic spice, turmeric. Look at the colour of that, right? So a teaspoon of turmeric goes in, and we can put a little bit of sesame oil in there. You could use olive oil if you want, but sesame oil's got that amazing flavour. And we'll rub that over the fish. So pound that up, rub it over the fish. You can go super fine or chunky, it doesn't matter. Give it 1 hour, half an hour, or overnight is really, really good. So rub that on the fish like so.
Jamie, you were just mentioning lockdowns and crazy lockdowns and people kind of not getting back to real life. You've had a few big milestones in your family over the past couple of years in lockdown, including your 20-year wedding anniversary. How did you celebrate?
We had our 20th wedding anniversary, we had our 21st wedding anniversary, and two teenage 18th birthdays, all in lockdown.
Wow.
And no party. So I have a feeling that it's all going to come back in one giant big party.
I hope so.
Like for a lot of people, whether it's Christmas, special occasions, we all know now, because we haven't legally been able to do it, how important these moments in normal family, like to be human, to be normal, is being able to have people you love come round, hang out.
And food brings people together.
Absolutely. So look, you've got your marinated fish. Here we go.
Yep.
I want to show you this technique for making the bag, but before I do that, if you've got like, a lot of people have liquidizers now for making like healthy smoothies and bits and pieces. These are fantastic, right? So what I've got in here is a tin of coconut milk. All of this, by the way, you can get in a regular supermarket. Handful of coriander. You can change up the herb if you want to. This one you can get fresh or dried. Lime leaves. Really, really interesting. I buy a bag when I see them down the market and I freeze them. That's the only tricky ingredient, I think. Ginger and garlic. Just a little thumb-sized piece. Some spring onions and chilli. Now, we're going to whiz that up until it makes a vivid green sauce. Whiz that up. The great thing about this is it blends all those flavours and those colours together, and you have this amazing, vivid green sauce, full of flavour. We're going to pour the sauce, just a little bit, like a ladle of that, onto there, and then we're going to lay up some lovely, fresh things. I've got some bok choy, pak choy, asparagus, you know, little sweet peas, things like that. Lovely health with French beans. You can really use whatever's in season. Then I've got the fish that I'm going to lay on top of that. I know you've got this, babe. You've got this. Look, you're killing
it. I got it.
one prawn and scallop.
Yes.
And then I'm just going to give it a little kiss of salt and a little drizzle of olive oil. What's really lovely about this technique is the magic happens when you cook it. And even if you put it together scruffily, this combination always works. So for a dinner party, for a nice dinner, it's going to come out amazing. So what we need to do now is fold it up like this, like an envelope. The tin foil, in a way, is kind of easier, but it's noisier, so sound men don't like it. But the greaseproof paper is also, you can just fold it up like a little envelope. And if you want to use egg wash, you can, but I'm just going to go straight for it. And that's what you end up with. Now, do you have a husband or a boyfriend?
Next question.
Okay, fair enough. When I first started dating my missus, we used to do split shifts. We were both working hard in the city. We never really saw each other. So I always used to do these little envelopes for the missus. You know, put cook at 180 for, you know, 15 minutes, little heart, maybe a little naughty message. And then when she came home from work, I wouldn't be there and she'd bang it in the oven. And if I was lucky, you never know. That's why I got five kids.
Any more on the horizon, I have to ask?
I don't think so, but you never know with my missus. She has this love affair with children. I can't quite work it out. I'm not that keen on them myself. she loves kids, mate. And I would like
to... And you make gorgeous children.
They are gorgeous children. I think we're done, but you never know with Jules. So, darling, that would go in the oven. After 15 minutes at 180, kind of looks like this.
Okay.
And...
Oh, yours looks good.
Have you not got a cooked one?
I'm coming out of the kitchen.
Yes,
I'm coming out of the kitchen to show you this. I'm sorry that you're half a world away.
That's all right.
But,
Is yours cooked?
No.
Yeah, you've got to put it in the oven and you've got to seal it up. You know, this is not sushi.
Okay.
It ain't sushi.
I know.
Shall I show you what a cooked one looks like?
Please, I'd love to see it, the real one.
So what's really nice is when you get your lovely fish in the bag, you can just open it up like this. It's the most amazing wow factor. You get the steam. Look at that steam. You get the colour. The ginger, the coriander, look at that. Absolutely beautiful. And then if you want to finish it with a few bits of chili, you can. But I would serve this with lovely steamed rice, or I've got a lovely little noodle and rice cake in this recipe. In the book, we've got all kinds of meals, dinners. So from brunches, lunches, dinners, like kind of more fancy ones, really humble ones, surprising ones. And that's what we've tried to do in the book. You know, that whole vibe of me helping you throw like an amazing dinner party, even for you, my darling. Honestly, if you do, if you follow the recipes, I've written it in a way that I hold your hand, so you get prepped up, and then when it comes to the kind of having your friends and family around, you're kind of free to just kind of do a great job. But look at that, absolutely beautiful.
It's like you're actually inside Jamie Oliver's kitchen. Thank you so much for the cooking lesson today. What a joy and an honour. I think the crew's going to fight over my dish.
Just make sure you cook it.
They're all just...
Find an oven.
It's not sushi. You take care. Love to the fam.
Lots of love, my darling. Take care.
Bye-bye.
I think you did quite well, all things considered.
The patience of a saint, you could say. His book is called Together, the Brand New Cookbook. It is out now, but he is so lovely. Literally 8 minutes in the kitchen with Jamie Oliver on the other side of the world. We've all got Jamie Oliver cookbooks, yeah. But actually being able to cook along with him, amazing.
Good on you.
Bucket list stuff.
I thought you'd done well.